One India News are. Get prepared for work from anywhere and wherever you get the opportunity. The next workplace revolution is happening now. Amidst the economic disruption being faced due to the pandemic, businesses that can still operate are being challenged with how best to ensure business continuity. In the case of these businesses, not everyone can work remotely, and for some sectors, employees still need to go to work. However, communication continues to be paramount when navigating through this crisis. It is of utmost importance that business leaders continue to update their staff on any and all changes that take place. The positive aspect of this transformation is that remote work presents significant opportunities and benefits for businesses. That is, 72% of remote workers have noted time savings and 66% cite financial savings as core benefits since the shift to remote work, all of which directly impact the bottom line. But the rapid transition to remote work has not come within this its challenges, especially on the security front, which has led to a variety of cyber attacks targeting remote workers specifically. There is a sharp rise in the unemployment level in many states in the country as millions of workers have lost their jobs. It brings an opportunity for the entrepreneurs to choose the right talent for their organizations. Work from anywhere jobs offers the ultimate in location flexibility and independence. Let's look into this hour's headlines in War India. Bharti Airtel-controlled Netel takes 100% stake in OneWeb India. Netel Infrastructure Investments, a wholly owned arm of Bharti Airtel, has acquired 100% stake in OneWeb India Communications Private Limited in an all-cash deal for an undisclosed sum. OneWeb is a low-Earth orbit, that is LEO satellite communications operator, co-owned by Bharti Global and the UK government, which is open to entering India either directly or through a commercial partnership involving either the JV route or a bandwidth capacity leasing pact, even as it gears up to launch fast broadband services in the country by June 2022. MasterCard to buy Ekata for $800 million deal to enhance digital ID verification. MasterCard has agreed to buy digital identity verification company Ekata in a deal valued at $850 million as the global payments processor bets on a boom in demand for companies in the digital security space. Ekata, headquartered in Seattle, has over 2,000 companies as its partners, helps businesses to separate fraudsters from legitimate customers during digital interactions, its website showed. MasterCard said that the deal is expected to close in the next 6 months. Zoom allocates $100 million fund to invest in startups using technology. The video conferencing company Zoom has become popular during the pandemic as businesses and schools shifted to its platform along with rival platforms Microsoft's Teams and Cisco Systems' WebEx. Now, the video conferencing platform Zoom has announced a $100 million global venture fund to invest in startups that are building apps using its technology. The Zoom Apps Fund will make an initial investment of $250,000 to $2.5 million in each portfolio company, Zoom said in a statement. Paytm to handle the payment gateway of LIC. Life Insurance Corporation of India, that is LIC, has appointed Paytm to facilitate its digital payments. Following a tie-up with another payment gateway earlier, the country's largest life insurer has sought a new deal as the majority of its payments have moved to digital modes. There are 17 payment platforms that have bid proactively for LIC's contract. However, Paytm's aptness to straddle multiple payment services worked in its favor since other players were leading in specific segments such as UPIs or cards. Ashish Kashyap joins as a board member in EuroKids. EuroKids, the company into the education domain, announced the appointment of Ashish Kashyap as the board member. Ashish has launched multiple businesses in online travel, including Ibibo, and built properties such as GoIbibo and Redbus. He also co-founded PayU India, formerly known as Ibibo Pay, and has recently joined Int Money. Before founding the Ibibo Group, Kashyap was country head of Google India. He has experience in building consumer internet and technology businesses from scratch and scaling them. That's it for now. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to War India News Magazine. Stay tuned. Thank you.